Greetings everybody, Ken here, and today we're going to be talking about phishing. Phishing is one of the easiest forms of cyber attack for criminals to carry out, and one of the easiest to fall for. It's also one that can provide everything hackers need to ransack their targets' personal and work accounts. Usually carried out over email, although the scam has now spread beyond suspicious emails to phone calls, so-called vishing, social media, messaging services, aka smishing, and apps, a basic phishing attack attempts to trick the target into doing what the scammer wants. Let's dive right into what phishing is and how to avoid the lure. The term phishing with a PH is a spin on the word phishing, because criminals are dangling a fake lure, a legitimate looking email, website, or ad, hoping users will bite by providing the information the criminals have requested, such as credit card numbers, account numbers, passwords, usernames, and other valuable information. And how do they do this? Well, this is usually done by including a link on quote fishy messages that appear to take you to a company's website to fill in your information, but the website is a clever fake, and the information you provide goes straight to the crooks behind the scam. Phishing goes all the way back to last century, yet as digital technologies progress, this technique continues to find new ways to exploit vulnerabilities. Here are some of the most common phishing techniques nowadays. Standard email phishing. Arguably the most widely known form of phishing, this attack is an attempt to steal sensitive information via an email that appears to be from a legitimate organization. It's not a targeted attack and can be conducted en masse. Malware phishing. Malware phishing uses the same techniques as email phishing, but this attack encourages targets to click a link or download an attachment so some kind of virus can be installed on the device. It's currently the most pervasive form of phishing attack, as it can not only compromise some of your information, but your whole computer. Spear phishing. While most phishing attacks cast a wide net, spear phishing is a highly targeted, well-researched attack generally focused at public personas, business executives, and other lucrative targets. Smishing. SMS-enabled phishing delivers malicious short links to smartphone users, often disguised as account notices, prize notifications, and political messages. Vishing. Vishing or voice phishing involves a malicious caller purporting to be from tech support, a government agency, or another organization, and tries to extract personal information such as banking or credit card information. Malvertising. This type of phishing utilizes digital ad software to publish otherwise normal-looking ads with malicious code implanted within. Spotting the lure. Even though there are numerous forms of phishing, the one that most people fall for is email scamming. Make no mistake, these attacks can be quite clever. After all, these types of phishing exist because they work. Luckily for you, there are numerous warning signs that can help you detect this type of phishing. And what better way to learn than with an example? Imagine this: you receive an email from Amazon claiming your account has been locked. You check the email and see that, number one, the email is not addressed to your email address. Number two, the header is addressed to Dear Customer instead of a personalized identifier that includes your name. Number three, a label that includes some text as exceeding the number of attempts allowed appears. Four, a lot of visual errors pop up. Words are capitalized throughout the text, punctuation, and the formatting is off. Five, the email tries to reassure you by encouraging you to confirm this information using a link they provide. Yet, if you hover over the links on the page, another web address appears. All of these elements are warning signs that the email must be a scam. First of all, if you were truly being notified by a company that there was an issue with your account, they would know your name and email already. Then, if you recall correctly, you must know that you haven't attempted to sign into your Amazon account lately. Thus, the information claiming that you exceeded the number of attempts allowed is false. Yet, this is where most people fall for the scam, as they think somebody must be entering into my account. I need to change my password. Well, if you suspect this, don't click the links on the email and go to the webpage directly. Here, you can truly see if people attempt to enter your account, and you can change your password if you desire to. As most of us only tend to skim through emails, visual errors and false links are easier to miss. Still, it's important to be aware that if a message is asking for sensitive information, we must be sure that we can trust it. Reading the message thoroughly is a great way to spot these warning signs and avoid being scammed. Becoming a shark. Now that you took the first step on learning what phishing looks like, here are some things to do to avoid falling for them and encountering them in the future. Number 1. Don't click on that link. As I said before, it's not advisable to click on a link in an email or instant message, even if you know the sender. The bare minimum you should be doing is hovering over the link to see if the destination is the correct one. Some phishing attacks are fairly sophisticated, and the destination URL can look like a carbon copy of the genuine site that's set up to record keystrokes or steal login or credit card information. If it's possible for you to go straight to the site through your search engine rather than click on the link, then you should do so. 2. Get free anti-phishing add-ons. Most browsers nowadays will enable you to download add-ons that spot the signs of a malicious website or alert you about the known phishing sites. They're usually completely free, so there's no reason not to have this installed on every device in your organization. Number 3. Don't give your information to an unsecured site. If the URL of the website doesn't start with HTTPS, or you can't see a closed padlock icon next to the URL, don't enter any sensitive information or download files from that site. Sites without security certificates may not be intended for phishing scams, but it's better to be safe than sorry. Number 4. Rotate passwords regularly. If you've got online accounts, you should get in the habit of regularly rotating your passwords so you prevent an attacker from gaining unlimited access. Your accounts may have been compromised without you knowing, so adding that extra layer of protection through password rotation can prevent ongoing attacks and lock out potential attackers. Don't ignore those updates. Receiving numerous update messages can be frustrating, and it can be tempting to put them off or ignore them altogether. Don't do this. Security patches and updates are released for a reason, most commonly to keep you up to date with modern cyber attack methods by patching holes in security. If you don't update your browser, you could be at risk of phishing attacks through known vulnerabilities that could have easily been avoided. Number 6. Don't give out important information unless you must. As a general rule of thumb, unless you 100% trust the site you're on, you should not willingly give out your credit card information. Make sure, if you have to provide your information, that you verify the website is genuine, that the company is real, and that the site itself is secure. So hopefully you found this video helpful. If so, please feel free to leave a thumbs up, as I always appreciate it. A good bit of digital validation feels oh so nice. Also, let me know any comments or questions you have. You know I love getting to answer as many of those as I can. Interacting with people who share the same passions as me is oh so cool. But otherwise, thanks so much for watching. Hope you have a great rest of your day. Stay safe out there, and I'll see you in the next video.